Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create an origami folded text logo using a great looking font called Origram, designed by Nuno Dias. I provided its link in the video description or project files. In addition, I provided a Photoshop file that includes this image created by Nuno, which shows how each character should be rendered to simulate the folds within them. You can reference them when you're ready to create the folds for your text. Once you install Origram, open your horizontal type tool and open the font. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial showing how to do it. I provided that link as well. I'll make the size 250 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click on the color box and pick a color that's not too light nor too dark. I'm picking 5989F7. Once you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Type out your text. To increase or decrease the overall space between the characters, highlight the line and go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Go to the tracking icon and drag it to the right or left. I'll set it at 0. To adjust the space between just two characters, place your cursor between them and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right or left arrow keys on your keyboard. To reposition your text, open your Move tool and move it. Temporarily close the character panel by clicking on this icon. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Click on the thumbnail of the samples layer to make the layer active. Since Z is the first letter of my logo, I'll drag the Z sample next to it. Press D on your keyboard to make the foreground and background colors default to black and white respectively. Open the Zoom tool by pressing Z on your keyboard. Drag it over that area to zoom into it. In this example, we need to darken these areas of the Z. Make your text layer active and open your rectangular marquee tool. We're going to render one shadow at a time. I'll start with this shadow. Carefully drag a selection over your character to the edge of where the shadow begins. Open your Burn tool and make sure the range is mid-tones and the exposure is 100%. Also, make sure your Caps Lock key on your keyboard is not on. Make the size 65 points and the hardness 0%. Press the F5 key to open your brush panel and make sure Shape Dynamics is not checked. Press the F5 key again to close the panel. I'll brush across the area 7 times. If you want your shadows to be lighter or darker, just brush over it less or more times. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, I'll brush in this shadow. Press M to open your Marquee tool and drag a rectangular selection up to the edge of where the shadow begins. Press O to open your Burn tool and again, brush across the same amount of times you did earlier. Delete the selection. To see the entire document at 100%, press Ctrl or Command plus 1. Make the samples layer active. Since the letter E is my second character, I'll press V to open my Move tool and drag the E sample next to my second character. Open your Zoom tool and drag over that area. Make the text layer active. The first shadow on this character will be this one, so I'll press M to open my Marquee tool and carefully drag a selection to the edge of where the shadow begins. Press O to open your Burn tool and again brush across the same amount of times as you did earlier. Then delete the selection. Continue this process until all your characters look like the samples. To see your entire document at 100%, press Control or Command 1. I'll add the shadows on the last letter of my logo based on its respective sample. Once you're done adding shadows, you can hide the sample's layer. We're ready to set the secondary line of text. Open your Type tool again and choose a font. For this example, I'll use a font called Labtop. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. For this font, I'll choose a point size of 29 and black for the color. Go below your logo and type out your text. To increase its tracking, highlight the text and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. To center both lines on your document, Shift-click on the logo to highlight both layers and press Ctrl or Command A. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon, then delete the selection. Make the background active and open your Elliptical Marquee tool. Go to the top left corner of your document and drag out a selection to the bottom right corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Go to the top right corner of the transform, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on Windows or Shift and Option on a Mac as you drag the transform in. Then go to the top middle, and when you see a vertical double arrow, repeat the steps as you drag the transform down. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 100 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Click on the foreground color and pick a light color. For this example, I'll left click on the medium color of my logo to pick up that color. Now I'll move my cursor to the left to pick up a lighter shade. When you've picked your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Fill the selection with that color by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Then delete the selection. If you want to give your entire image a paper-like texture, make a composite snapshot by making your top layer active and pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. Choose Sandstone, make the scaling 100%, the relief 2, and the light is from the top. Then click OK. If you'd like to adjust its color, you can do it a few ways. Click on the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Hue Saturation. Go to Hue and slide it to the right or left. Another way is to choose color balance and in midtones, slide the three color adjustments until you like the color of your image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.